driving to our test site where we do our test flights. Yeah, we're just going to check out if everything works. Basically, a full-on system test of the new payload.
Are you anticipating any problems?
Never.
I remember the first time when I played around with drones. You had RC helicopters, you had RC airplanes, and this quadcopter thing that was just starting out. And then everything would kind of get smaller and get more powerful. And then the AI came in with the algorithms to do sensorless flight, basically. We want to have drones not as something you buy and you use as a customer, but it's an app. What do you need? You click it, a drone goes off, it comes back, and suddenly you have the data. And that's the vision going into the next years, that Quantum becomes this big drone service, aerial intelligence service provider.
When we talk about aerial intelligence, there is no mission that is impossible. Agriculture, linear infrastructure, mining, disaster monitoring, wildfire detection, disaster relief missions. Basically, the sky is the limit here. I just carry a border system. The story about Quantum is the story about deep tech and engineering and passion. My parents, I can remember they took me to Frankfurt. There's like a watchtower where you can see the operations on the airfield. Being a young boy, that was just amazing to see these airliners come in and take off. I think that was the beginning of all of it. And then I continued building RC models, soldering my first PCBs and all of that.
Yeah, and this is the future of Quantum. This is where we take aerial intelligence to the next level. Complete automation of the takeoff and the landing procedure using a robotic arm that is automatically catching and releasing the drone and then stowing it away. This is what we're working on. Future of drones.
So plug in the battery, nice and tight.
The beep, and now we're basically ready to fly. If you look at the drone and what makes a drone work, initially we think it's the propellers and the motors, but there's way more. None of that would fly if we wouldn't have the avionics. So that's the flight controller, that's the actuators and all that. We also put AI into the drone, so now you need basically a computer that's inside of the drone. In our current product, there's about 15 PCBs. It has SODIMM connectors that carry AI processors. It has different sensors on it. And then there's SSDs. It really is a flying computer.
I think it's crucial to pick the right software. More than ever, it is important now that all these tools that we use, they are connected.
We wanted to grow in professionality. We want to grow in complexity. So we needed something that would be able to handle all that. And for me, it was clear that Altium was the right tool to do that. In Altium 365, we have all the information we need. We don't have to look it up. It's all there. So procurement sees what they need to see with the bombs, and then the assembly sees the assembly assistant, and then the embedded engineers see the schematic designs, and they give commentaries and so on. If we look at the 40-hour week, if I didn't have all the tools that Altium provides me now, more or less a quarter of my week would be clarifying questions or talking about designs and explaining stuff. With Altium 365, that rapidly changed, and I can now be more on a top-level design process.
So now what the user has to do is defining the area that he wants to map, and from that polygon, the flight path is created.
Mission successfully uploaded.
Okay, yeah. Next step is to place the drone, and then we are ready to take off.
I think that drones will become part of our lives.
Taking aerial intelligence to the next level means everything that you can see with your eyes, and that's basically everything we can monitor with a drone.
Drones will become kind of like a service. It will be fully automated. It will take off automatically, land automatically, be charged. The data will be automatically processed.
We have much, much bigger problems to come, and drones can play a critical and vital part in that as well. There's a lot of areas where drones and robotics and aerial intelligence will make a difference.
Thank you for watching Altium Stories. By subscribing and hitting the bell icon, you'll never miss out on the latest engineering stories from our channel.